press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hi students. So in the previous class, we were discussing about properties of quadrilaterals. So there we have learned that the angle sum property of quadrilaterals, sum of angles in a quadrilateral. So this is will be equal to 360 degree. So in general, this is one thing. In general, for any polygon of n sides, sum of interior angles. Sum of interior angles is equal to n minus 2 into 180. So this is why when we take n is equal to 2, it becomes n is equal to 4 for quadrilateral, it becomes 4 minus 2. 4 minus 2 is 2. 2 into 180 is 360. So using this formula, we can find the sum of the interior angles of any quadrilateral. It may be for triangle, it may be for quadrilateral, pentagon, hexagon, of a polygon of any number of sides. And thirdly, we have for any polygon. So exterior angle, total of exterior angle. Is equal to 360 degree. So this is fixed, whether it is for a triangle or for a quadrilateral or pentagon, whatever it is. For all, say, if any polygon of n sides, you can say, polygon of n sides. So exterior angle total will be 360 degree. So these things we have learned yesterday. So, and to consolidate this knowledge, so let us take up few problems on this concept. So I will take up problem number one. So in the given figure, find angle C. So this is the question, and the figure is this one. This is A, B, C, D. So angle A is 115 degree. This is given 115 degrees. Angle B is also given. B is 95 degree. And B is also given. B is 45 degree. So this is 45 degree. So we have to find the angle C. So it is a simple problem, of course. So answer by angle sum property of quadrilateral so we have the sum of four angles, angle A plus angle B plus angle C plus angle D is equal to 360 degree. So this one 360 degree. So here A, B and D are given. You substitute the values. So A is 115 plus B is 95 degree, C is not known and D is 45 degree is equal to 360. So therefore C will be equal to 360 degree minus 115 minus 95 minus 45. So C will be equal to 360 degree minus, if you add these two, these three, 115, 95 plus 45. So you will get 255 degree. 360 minus 255, that is 105 degree. So angle C is 105 degree. So this is what is to be proved. So therefore we have solved the problem. Sum of four angles is 360 degree. Three angles are given. We can find the fourth one. So I'll take up problem number 2. So in the given figure Find angle A, angle B, angle C and angle D. So all four we have to find out. So then what is the figure given? So figure given is like this. This is the figure. Now it is A B C D. This is A, this is B, this is C and this is D. Now so what is given is A angle is given as, observe this, A angle is given as 3x plus 9. This is not the side length, this is the angle value 3x plus 9. 3x plus 9. angle B is given 5x plus 20. 5x plus 20. 5x plus 20. C is 3x. So this value I will write outside, 3x. And D value is given. D value is 2x plus 6. 2x plus 6. So this is, these are the angle values given. So again, using the angle sum property, we can solve this problem. So answer by angle sum property, sum property of a quadrilateral the four angles A plus B plus C plus D, of course all angles, angle A plus angle B, angle C and angle D, is equal to 360 degree. So A is, you can see, 3x plus 9, this is A value. B is 5x plus 20, C is 3x and D is 2x plus 6. 2x plus 6 is equal to 360 degree. So add all x values, you will get 3x plus 5x is 8x, 8x plus 3x, 11x, 11x plus 2x is 13x. So 13x plus odd all numbers, 9 plus 20, 29 plus 6. So 29 plus 6 is 35. So therefore plus 35, all plus values, so 35 is equal to 360 degree. So 13x equals 360 minus 35 is equal to 325 degree. So x will be equal to 325 divided by 13. 325 divided by 13. So x will be equal to, you will get 25. So 13 twos are 26. So we will get 4 plus 2, 65 is remaining. So 13 into 5 is 65. So 325 is 325. We got the x value. So therefore, we have to find A, B, C, D. Now x is equal to 25 degree. So therefore, now I will erase this. So therefore, A will be equal to, A value is 3x plus 9. So here x is equal to 25. So therefore, I will take 3 into 25 plus 9. So 75 plus 9. So 84 degree. So angle A equals 85 degree. Now B will be equal to 5x plus 20. So 5 into 25 plus 20. 5 into 25 is 125. 125 plus 20, so angle B is 145 degree. Now angle C is 3x, angle C is 3x, that is 3 into 25 is equal to 75 degree. So finally angle D, so angle D equals 2x plus 6, 2 into 25 plus 6, so 2 into 25 is 50, 50 plus 6 is equal to 56 degree. So therefore angle A is 84 degree, B is 145 degree, C is 75 degree and D is 56 degree. So have a check, if you add all these four angles it should be 360 degree, that is the check you can apply. So I'll take up next problem. So problem 3, in a quadrilateral angle A, B, C and D are in the ratio or in the ratio three is to 5 is to 4 is to 8. A, B, C, D are in the ratio 3 is to 5 is to 4 is to 8. Find the angles. Find the angles. So this is the problem. Now you know that the sum of all four angles is 360 degree. So therefore you can proceed like this. Answer: let x be the common multiple. Of all angles. So therefore by angle sum property of quadrilateral so what we can have 3x plus 5x plus 4x plus 8x is equal to 360 degree. It is simple now. Now, if you total this, it becomes 20x is equal to 360 degree. Therefore, x is equal to 360 divided by 20. So, x is equal to 18. So, when x is 18, we can calculate the remaining angles. Therefore, they are in the ratio 3x, 5x, 4x, 8x. So, therefore, A will be equal to 3 into x, that is 3 into 18 equals 54 degree. Now, angle B is equal to, angle B is 5x, so 5x, 5 into 18, 68 degree. No, 90 degree. Now, angle C will be equal to, 4. So, 4x, 4 into 18 is equal to 70 degree. D will be equal to 8x. So, 8 into 18, 144 degree. Just double the angle C. So, A plus B plus C plus D, if you add these things, so this is 360 degree. You can check that 4 plus 4, 8, 8 plus 2, 10, 1 is the carry, 5, 12 plus 9, 21 plus 5, 26, 2 is the carry, 2 plus 1, 360 degree. So, the angle sum property also satisfies. So, we have found out the all the four angles. Fourth problem, in a regular hexagon, problem number 4, in a regular hexagon, in a regular hexagon, find the following. One, sum of the interior angles. Sum of interior angles second, each interior angle Third one, sum of all exterior angles. Fourth one, each exterior angle. So these four things we have to find out. So you know, a regular figure is one, a regular hexagon. Hexagon is one which is having six sides and six angles. And a regular hexagon means all six sides are equal and all six angles are equal. So therefore, first we shall draw a diagram. So a hexagon will be like this. This is a hexagon. Now if I name this as say A, B, C, D, E, F. See all these interior angles, angle A, angle B, angle C, angle D, angle E and angle F. They will be equal. So now, first one, sum of interior angles. So, first one, sum of interior angles of n polygon is given by, we have is equal to n minus 2 into 180. So we have this general formula where n is equal to 6. Put n equal 6 because the given problem, it is a hexagon. So therefore, it is equal to 6 minus 2 into 180. So that equals 4 into 180, so 720 degree is the sum of the interior angles, angle A plus B plus C plus D plus E plus F will be 720 degree. So sum of all interior angles. Now second one, each interior angle, see, when the total is 720, sum of, so I will write here, so this is A plus B plus C plus D plus E plus F, so this is nothing but 720. Now each interior angle is obviously 720 divided by 6. So therefore, each interior angle, general formula is n minus 2 divided by 180 into 180 divided by n. That is, you have to divide this by number of sides. 720 divided by 6 is equal to 120. So each angle is 120 degree interior angle. So this is also 120 degree. Now observe here, if I extend this BC, I will extend this BC. You can see here, I have extended BC here. This is a straight line, I have extended BC, the total must be 180, because this is 120, this will be 60 degree. Exterior angle is 60 degree. So sum of all exterior angles, so how many exterior angles are there? 1, 2, there will be 6. So therefore 6 into 60, 360. So the general rule is for any polygon, the exterior angle total is 360 degree. You can simply write that. So sum of all exterior angles in any polygon, sum of all exterior angles is equal to 360 degree. So this is general for all, even for triangle this is 360 degree. Now finally, each exterior angle, so in this case there are 6 angles, we have to divide 360 by 6. So therefore we will get, and right here fourth one, each exterior angle, fourth one, each exterior angle angle. So exterior angle total is 360 degree. So 360 divided by, there are 6 vertices, 6 angles divided by 6. So therefore 60 degree, you can see here, you will get 60 degree at all vertices. If you extend CD, here also you will get 60. If you extend DE, here also you will get 60 degree. So this completes question number 4. Now question number, problem number 5, problem number 5. In the given figure, in the given figure, Find angle A, angle C and angle D. So these three we have to find out. So then what is the figure given? Observe this figure. We have a figure like this. Observe this carefully. So here we call this as A, B, C, D is the quadrilateral, and this is AD is extended, and this is point A, and BC is extended, this is point F. Now, it is given this angle, exterior angle value is given as 108 degree, and this is 137 degree, and exterior angle DCE is 153 degree. So this is the data given. So as for the given sketch, these are the data given. We have to find angle A, angle C, and angle D. Now, answer. Now, observe here, BA is extended up to E, BA is extended up to E, EAB is 108 degree. So, therefore, angle DAB, so this angle plus EAB, this angle, the total is 180 degree. So, from figure what we can read, DAB plus EAB is equal to 180 degree. Reason is they are linear pair. So EAB is given, it is 108 degree. DAB equals DAB plus 108 is equal to 180. So therefore DAB equals 180 minus 108 is equal to 72 degree. So we have found out angle A. Angle A means this value we have found out, it is 72 degrees. Now similarly, you calculate angle BCD. So BCD plus DCF is equal to, again they are, these two are linear pair, so 180 degree. So it is 153. So BCD equals 180 minus DCF. DCF is 153. So this equals 27 degree. 180 minus 153 is 27 degree. So therefore this is 27 degree. Now we are left with D. We have found out A, B, C. So therefore we can find D, because the total of all four angles is 360 degree. So therefore I will write by angle sum property of quadrilateral. So for triangle it is 180, for quadrilateral it is 360. So we will write angle A plus B plus C plus D, so is equal to 360 degree. We have 3, so therefore we can find out the last one. So I will write here, angle A is 72 degree, 72 + 137 B + 27 these three plus D is equal to 360. So if you add up these three, you will get therefore D equals 360 degree minus of all these three. So 72 + 137 + 27. So 209 + 29, you will get 236. So therefore, angle D is equal to 124 degree. So this is 124 degree. Now we have found out all the angles. So this is 124 + 72 + 137 + 27. If you add up all these three angles, you will get 360 degree. So this completes fifth problem. So today I will stop at this stage. So in the next class I will take up types of quadrilaterals. So next important topic. So especially in your class under quadrilaterals, you will be studying mainly about one special type of quadrilateral, that is parallelogram and types of parallelogram. So mainly you will have to concentrate on those things. So whatever I have taught you till this class in 2-3 classes, this is basic for quadrilaterals. So next class onwards, you will study more about parallelograms and types of parallelograms. So thank you, students.